Hi guys, thanks for watching this video. This is a new house build by me, duh. And it's a semi-detached house. So I don't know what you guys call it in like other countries, but in Singapore we call it semi-detached. Because it's two houses attached to each other and there's like a shared wall in the middle. So yeah, it's called semi-detached. Maybe you call it townhouses elsewhere, but yeah. So this was actually inspired by many of the houses here in Singapore. Yeah, there's a lot of semi-detached houses, and I actually saw one of the houses when I was gonna go eat dinner with my friends, and it looked kind of like the one I built. Maybe a bit of variation, but the roof was mainly inspired by that house that I saw. So as you can see, I'm still building a roof. It actually took me quite a while to finish the roofs because I'm quite bad at roofs and I'm not very used to the Sims 4 controls for roofing. So it took me quite a while to try and align that curved part of the roof. So yeah, this video is like 30 minutes plus long, so it will take me quite a lot of time to like talk. Maybe I'll just cut myself off halfway, but yeah. So if you can see, like half of it is more modern and the other is contemporary, I guess. Let me Google that. Yes, it is a contemporary house on the right and a modern house on the left, I think. I don't know all these terms, but yes. Okay, so the only problem I had with this build was that the plot had an even number of squares, so there's no like fair division among both houses. So the modern house on the left is actually one tile bigger than the one on the right. But in the end, it actually worked out because there was quite a lot of space for both houses. Okay, so yeah, I'm just like doing the windows and stuff. And I'm sorry if it's like a bit too fast because it was actually at times 12 and times 10 speed. But I had to double it up because the video was like 40-50 minutes long and ain't nobody gonna watch that shit. So damn long. So yeah, I cut it down by half, so now it's like 30 minutes. And now I'm like putting the windows. It's like quite hard to find nice windows because there's not much windows to choose from, and the windows that are there, the only problem is that there's no creator style like Sims 3, so the windows don't have the same color as the other designs that I want to choose from. Yep, and yeah, that's the only problem I had. Other than that, it was fine. So now I'm just painting the exterior, finding a nice color for it. So I actually settled with like a cream color for the modern house and a blue and a brick finish for the contemporary one. So yep, I'm now just partitioning the house into rooms. It was actually quite difficult for me to do it because it's like a very long house and I did not want to break the house up into like many different rooms for the modern house, because modern houses are really very open plan, like high ceilings, long rooms, light from one end to the other end. So that was what I'm trying to accomplish. So as you can see, I'm actually like dividing it into rooms, but I gave up after that and just left it as one huge room and just a small little area for the toilet. So yeah. Okay, this is the contemporary one. Okay, actually it's not contemporary if you look at it. Maybe the exterior is contemporary, but the interior is more traditional, more Victorian. Yeah, it's the kind of style I'm trying to go for is like, it's an originally Victorian home, then it got renovated, and that's why you can see like the main building is made of brick and the rest is painted. So you know, maybe that's like what the owners did. They made some extensions to the house and made it so that the exterior looks a bit more up to date. But the interior is very grand and very luxurious. So yeah, that's why it's more Victorian in the inside than the outside. Okay, now I'm doing the interior for the modern house. So for me, I actually find it easier to furnish the house before I paint the interiors. I don't know why, I just find it hard to paint, to visualize what color goes with the furniture. So I always do the furniture first before I do the walls and the flooring. So yeah, I actually use quite a lot of custom content furniture. I actually told myself that I will not use custom content, but someone urged me to because they are actually quite nice stuff to download. So yep, I did. Oops, I have a call. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, so okay, maybe I'll mute that part. Okay, where are we now? Okay, we are in bitch. Are you fucking kidding me? Hold on. Hello? Hello? Yeah? Wrong number. Oh yeah, sorry, yeah. Can, sure. Yeah. Okay. Thanks. Ugh, so annoying. That was KFC calling me. Okay, anyway. Okay, the kitchen is like, okay, as you can see, the living room area is going for this like cream black theme. Basically very clean. Clean kind of finish. So it's like very white. Then black to contrast the whiteness. Yep. So yeah, and I actually put the dining room first before the the kitchen. I know it's not usual for many houses to have them like, you know, come into a dining room, but my house actually is the dining room is the first thing you see. But yeah, the kitchen is not at the far end. The kitchen is right beside the dining room, but that's fine. You know, it's a new concept. Maybe I'm a trendsetter, who knows. Okay, so now I'm doing the master bedroom. Yeah, the master bedroom is kind of like a loft, so there's no actual door. So if like the sun comes up and sees the parents having sex, I'm like, okay. I did not think about that, but yeah, maybe the son is old enough to know that the parents need privacy and he should not go to the top floor unless there is a fire or there is a burglar or he is menstruating, I don't know. Yeah. So, yep, I'm just doing the furnishing for that. And yeah, The Sims that are gonna live here are actually gonna be one family, because you know you can't have two separate families in one plot of land. So it's gonna be two different families but under the same household. So the one living in a modern house, they will have a delinquent son, you know, very emo, very seen. That's why right now I'm building his room, it's very black, very dark. And yeah, and the parents are in the police force, so you know how that works out. Okay, and yep, what else? Yeah, you know what, you just watch my let's play if I'm gonna make an episode on that. then you'll know what happens. I will introduce the families. But yeah, just trying to make give you some perspective on the people living here. So this room is for an emo kid who likes to go to the club, play loud music and smoke weed and stuff, I don't know. I don't know what delinquents do because I'm a very innocent and angelic boy, so I'm not a delinquent. So yep. And right outside his room, the second floor, I actually wanted to do like, you know, a creative area like piano, workbench and all that kind of stuff, but you know what? These parents are cool, they have a cool house, so they're gonna have a club. Okay, not a club, maybe a bar. But yep, they have a bar so that the son's friends can come over and like, you know, party and get drunk and stuff. You know, it's better getting drunk in their own house than getting drunk outside and getting into trouble. So yep, it's a very cozy bar, not a huge bar, just cozy. So yeah, just filling up the places with custom content I just downloaded. Looks very modern, the art. And what else am I doing? Oh, and I love that huge leaning mirror. I always wanted one of that in my house, but my house is has no space. No, actually I have no money for that thing in the first place. So yep, even though if I have space, I cannot buy that mirror in the first place. So yep, where are we now? Okay, so now we are doing the ensuite for the master bedroom at the top floor. Okay, it's actually done. Okay, yep. And now I'm just adding some clutter around like the desk and stuff to look like people actually live there. So yep, that is the parents. Yep, that photo, even though it's like from in-game, I made my Sims according to how they look in that photo. So that's kind of cool, you know, kind of, I don't know, I guess it's cool to me. Okay, now I'm doing the contemporary Victorian home. So yep, I'm trying to like check how big the house is. Just like placing down the big objects I have to get it in first. So I place the dining table first so I got a sense of space, how much space I have for the kitchen area. I actually wanted to put an island, but I actually had no space for it, so I scratched that idea and just had just a normal kitchen, nothing special about it. Just a very long countertop kitchen with all the appliances that you need because they are freaking rich. If you watch till the end of the video, you can see that they have loads of expensive paintings. Yep. So, trying to contrast from the house on the left. So this is more traditional, you know, contrasting families, different type of personalities. So it'll be a very, very interesting kind of family interaction. So yep, just adding like decorations and stuff, paintings, and actually wanna put like some curtains, but you know what, the windows are not the same, so I just did not put any curtains. Okay, and that is all for the kitchen, I believe, and now we are going into the bathroom, which is on the first floor. Just a sink and a toilet. And now I used that pedestal thingy. I thought it was kind of cool. It looks like a centerpiece kind of table, you know, for like people to come in, put their stuff, cannot put their stuff, to like look at themselves before they leave the house, maybe. So yeah, the living room is kind of like muted, not much items. Just, okay, there's a freaking grand piano, okay, it's not really that muted. But yeah, it's not much going on as compared to the modern house living room. Yep, just like some couches, no coffee table, and a TV, and a piano. So yeah, the people living here are very, you know, musically inclined. They're very smart, you know, very snobbish because they're very rich. But you know, good can come out from that kind of personalities. So let's see. I mean, you see, because I have already seen it. So now I am doing the second floor. I actually had kind of trouble with the stairs because sims 4 has very weird stairs. Like the triangle piece under the stairs, it does not match up with a wall that you built. So it's very weird. But you know, I worked around that because I am a survivor and stuff. Okay, so now I'm building whose room is this? The little girl's room. She is like a music prodigy, but you know, the parents love her, so they give her everything in pink. Yep, she's very princessy, but you know, she is smart at the same time. So she got a nice room of her dreams. And yep, I cannot wait until that daughter grows up so that I can upgrade the room. Not upgrade, change the room to fit her teenage personality. So yeah, just adding in more clutter under the table. And I moved all the furniture, like half a tile in, because I did not want it to clash with the curtains. I mean the blinds. Now I'm doing the shared bathroom between the little girl's room and the teenage son's room for the Victorian home. The teenage son is more of a artsy, fartsy kind of guy. He goes to Yale, that kind of guy, you know. Very smart, not snobbish, just very reserved, quiet, and you know, keeps to himself, just paints every day, take photographs, he's a photographer. So yeah, that's why you can see lots of cameras. Later I will put it beside his bed. Yeah, he has tons of cameras, even the old ones. And yeah, nothing much going on in his room. No TV, because he paints a lot. That's his bread and butter, that's what he finds fun in. So yep, very cozy nonetheless. And okay, here is where I put the cameras. And his room is actually kind of dark because of the type of lamp I used, the ceiling light I used. So I tried my best to like put bedside table lamps and like wall lamps at places that are quite dark. But yeah, actually it makes him kind of mysterious that his room is dark. Yep. Okay, I'm getting kind of thirsty, but you know, I will press on. Oh, I got another call. Hold on. Hello? How much? I have no money. That's not enough. 15. Okay, sorry, that was my brother who is coming back from the hospital and he wants me to pay for his cab fare. But I ain't got no money, but actually I have some money. I'm just stingy. But you know, I'll just pay him whatever he needs. Not whatever he needs, I have a quota. I mean, I have a limit of $15, which you all have heard. Very personal information. But you know, we are close like that. Okay, anyway, we are at the master bedroom for the very antiquated home. You see, there was like a painting with like the curtains around, like, you know, kind of like a Mona Lisa kind of painting. It's the most expensive painting in Sims 4, so that is why it's very, you know, protected. And as you can see from the kind of room that they are living in, they are very like snobbish, very materialistic, cares more about themselves more than the kids, even though they give the kids whatever they want. Oh hell no, guys, I have to be right back because I have to go pay for this freaking cab fare. Be right back. Okay, I'm back from eating all that fried chicken. Yummy. Okay, so I'm not gonna be talking much because the video is coming to an end and the tour is starting soon. So yeah, all I did here was just wallpaper and flooring. So see you after the introduction of the completed house. I'll see you at the tour. My name is Marcy and I'm your real estate agent. So I'm gonna be showing you two houses. So in we go into this white lovely gate and into this home fully furnished. The house comes with a grand piano. Okay, I'm so sorry because the previous owners are still living here. So this is the living area and the seating area. So the piano, the lovely pedestal with the flower pots. Yep, lovely white couches, nice paintings, nice wood paneling, and nice stone accents on the wall. Very lovely, very Victorian. So right now we're gonna go in to the dining room / kitchen where our previous owners are still eating at. Sorry about the dirty dishes and the smelly owners. So yeah, this is the dining room. Very antiquated, very grand, luxurious, nice pine wood cabinets and countertops, and very lovely long dining table. I like it long. So yeah, and it's a renovated kitchen. So you have everything you need. Okay, now we're gonna go into the toilets. So yeah, it's just a lovely toilet with a big mirror for your guests to use when they visit your house. Okay, so right now we're gonna leave the owners alone in the dining room, and we're gonna go upstairs to the second floor. And look, there's like lovely paintings everywhere, nice walls, we already said that, but yeah, nice walls, a nice stairway. Okay, now we're gonna go into the children's room, which could be yours for the price of $5 million. So yeah, very nice and pink and white. For a rich person. Oh, I'm so sorry, there's like a kid sleeping in the bed. We did not anticipate this, but yes, it's a lovely room. As you can see, she's sleeping. Oops, so sorry, totally forgot to paint that wall, so let me paint it right now. I'm gonna get my paint roller and paint the wall right in front of you. And I am going to, which is right now. I'll paint the walls. Okay, so there's nothing wrong with this house. Everything is painted very nice and lovely and rich. So now, oops, we went upstairs. Okay, let's go back down. Okay, now we're gonna go to the other bedroom, which is for another child. It could be a guest bedroom, it's up to you. Okay, sorry, we're like floating outside the house. Just bear with me, we can float outside together. Okay, now we're gonna go in to the bedroom number two. So it's big enough for a queen size bed or king size, I don't know your sizes, so I don't judge. So lovely black and white walls, no, gray and black walls, with a nice big mirror. As you can see, very nice. Yeah, it's just nice. I have no other words for it. It's really nice. everything will come with the house if you buy the house for $5 million. Okay, I'm so sorry. The owner has come to check on us, but it'll be fine. So this is the balcony for this bedroom. Oops, I'm so sorry. We kind of defy the laws of physics here, so let me fix that real quick. So I'm gonna remove that lamp, ceiling light, and replace it with like a wall lamp. So I'm gonna put a nice wall lamp so it'll be lit up at night. And yeah, so there we go. So now we're gonna go back into the tour and go upstairs this time. So let's leave this lovely black and gray room. Very nice aesthetic. We're gonna go upstairs. Excuse me. We're gonna go upstairs to the master bedroom, which is lovely. It's really very Victorian. It is so grand. It could be all yours just for $50 million. Just $50 million. Okay. So the owner is sleeping. So let's just ignore that. Lovely paintings on the wall with their own painting light or whatever you call it. So yeah, nice and grand. Nice parquet wood flooring, floorboards, whatever, and a nice and expensive painting for you to look at whenever you wake up. So yeah. Excuse me. Okay, so this is the office with a nice expensive painting at the top. Yep. And a nice big mirror for your vanity. And yeah, a nice flat screen TV. So let's go into the master bedroom, the ensuite, which is French. You see, I'm so bilingual. So yeah, very nice bathtub, nice sink, very antiquated, a separate place for your toilet, for your poo-poo. So yeah, now we're gonna go to the huge balcony where you can have like your cigars, you can have your sex sessions there. I don't know, I don't judge you. Yeah, it's very big. Okay, right now we're gonna go to the modern house. Before we are at the contemporary house, which was $55 million, and this part of the house is not included in the $55 million, so this is actually $72 million. So now we're gonna go in this nice grand entrance to a nice big open plan living area. Okay, it's actually the dining room, but you know, it's all open plan, so there's no boundaries. Everything is one. We are all one, like the earth. We are all interconnected, as said by Buddhism. Yes. Nice big mirrors to make the room look huge. So now we're gonna go and look at the living room with the huge TV, which will be yours if you buy the house at $82 million. Yes. And very nice colors, a pop of red here and there, because white and black alone is very boring. So a pop of red, a red armchair, and red walls. A very nice and minimalistic kitchen with a nice accent brick wall at the back. And now we're gonna go into the first floor bathroom, which someone just pooped in, and it looks very nice. Geometric shapes, circles, squares, rectangles, all the shapes you can find it in this house, all for $92 million. Okay, $92 million, final offer, it's so cheap. So right now, excuse me, we're gonna go upstairs through this very modern stairs and look, lovely. And now we're gonna go in to the club. Actually, it's a bar, but yeah, it can be a club because there's a stereo system, a bar, a dance floor. It's everything you ever wanted.
if you want to hold parties, this is the perfect place. People can come here and have a drink. You can have like cigars. I don't know if you allow smoking in your house, but yes, you can have anything. You can turn on the spotlight. Okay, right now we're gonna go into the second floor bedroom, which is a teenager's room. So very black and white, very scene, very emo. Books and paintings, which is black and white. He has a goldfish because he gets lonely once in a while. And look, a nice dining table. No, not dining table. What's it called? Computer table with Vaseline and tissues for your teenage son to like clean up after himself, after he is finished, if you know what I mean. Okay, now we're gonna go in to the attached bathroom, which is a lovely, so beautiful. Look, it's so nice. Nice gray floor tiles and nice gray wood paneling, and also a nice accent brick wall, and also a nice mirror to watch yourself like take a nice bubble bath. Okay, now we're gonna go out of the second floor bedroom and go up to the loft, which is the master bedroom. There's no door for this and for the loft because, you know, we are in the 21st century. We're all very open-minded, so if you catch your parents having sex, that's fine. Just brush it off, just go wash your eyes with bleach and you'll be fine. So yep, very nice dining. Why do I keep saying dining? I mean computer desk. All could be yours. Computer desk, the house, all yours for only 102 million. And the nice attached bathroom with a nice jacuzzi with a nice leaning mirror. Yes. Lovely. Very nice. And just remember, it all could be yours. This side of the house, this half only for 150 million. The other half is 130 million. So together, if you add that both together, it's 150 plus 130. That is $502 million for this lovely semi-detached home, which is renovated, and everything comes at under that price of half a billion. Yep, it's very cheap. Very cheap. Okay, thanks for coming along with this tour.